Davey Richards. Have you heard about that?
Didn't he get, because he was doing cocaine or something?
No. Well, I'll get to that. I want to fucking pull that up because he has a whole.
I saw that, and then he retorted saying this is angry wife stuff, blah, blah, blah. I don't know. I think to myself when I heard that story initially, I didn't look too deeply into it.
Oh, I got it here. Yeah. Go on.
Well, no, I just think I'm like, there's got to be a reason that Davey Richards was never able to go farther than he did. And it's not just because he's short or timing is bad, but there's something up with him to the point that people saw and, you know, experienced how he acted. And they were like, yeah, we can't do business with this guy. Do you know what I mean?
So here was his initial statement. Let's go back to March of 2023, March 18th, long time ago. And talking about
his. I was still only 39.
Yes.
Yeah,
a long time ago. He said, hello, everyone. Wow, what a couple of days. There are allegations of domestic violence against me. The allegations I adamantly deny. And if you look on CaseNet in Missouri under my name, Wesley David Richards, you'll see that there are no charges filed against me. However, I do understand that the industry's stance on this matter. Everyone should feel safe, it shows, and I do not want to be the person whom damages that. The pic being posted of my wife's eyeball is from training, and we regularly train in martial arts, as many of the students have gotten black eyes and such. Again, no charges were filed. I deny these allegations, but I must do what is right and not what I want. So I'm canceling myself. The great sport is far too wonderful for anyone, including myself, to tarnish it. I will wrap up the shows this weekend, and I will be retiring from professional wrestling. Please continue to support Team Ambition and the sport. That was in March of 18 of the 2023, but now
Nobody's thought of it since. Oh wait, no, more shit happened.
Oh, well, as of June 8th.
Oh, okay. See, I didn't know.
So big fucking time gap there. The last 3 months have been, wow, tempestuous to say the least. Things have gotten very dark for a while for me. At one point, I planned on taking my own life. Sounds too surreal to think that I was in that state, to have a couple of bitter exes do through the trouble, turn, and effort to spread these false informations about me to destroy my wrestling career. Dude, what are you talking about? You literally a month ago or 3 months ago canceled yourself. You said that it was a misunderstanding and it was a black eye. And now it's them just tarnishing your career and getting rid of your wrestling career. You retired. You even said, fuck it, leave me alone. I'm done.
Right. Then, and you were lucky enough that people didn't care about you enough to do so.
Oh, fucking.
They actually did just leave you alone.
So. What an attention. Anyways, a career that I came back to with no other intent than just to give back was harrowing. Worst. They succeeded in doing so. I could have sought vengeance. Vengeance! But those who seek vengeance should start by digging two graves. Jesus.
Oh, dude, he's listening to some fucking hate breed. He's getting... He's like, the honor of my sacrifice will never be destroyed. He's so good.
Since that time, that accuser has admitted her claims were false, and the other, well, that's her cross to bear. Jesus, you're reading like a teenage goth girl's diary, motherfucker. I've dedicated my life to helping others through the pain of wrestling and medicine. To claim I was intentionally hurting others was heartbreaking. But worse again, everyone bought it because you said it was true. You fucking nonce. He said, I did hit her in the eye, but it was an accident. It was a martial art. Now you're saying it just never happened at all?
Oh,
I really wanted to use my last year or so in wrestling to give back and give the vast amounts of knowledge. And now he's starting Jesse fucking Ventura. Vast amounts of knowledge back to the sport that has given me so much. But
they
it
came
looks
after
like,
me with thermite paint.
But it looks like that was not meant to be. Oh. But the darkest days
always bring the brightest of mornings.
I've rededicated myself to my study of medicine, my love of grappling, and most of all, being a father.
If I hold on to the bitterness and apathy as those whom tarnished my name, then I am no better than them. So I forgive them. I was given a talent by God above for wrestling and for medicine. No one can take that from me. And it is my responsibility to use my talents and passions to help and serve humanity. Today I can say I am happier than I've been in a very long time. I have peace and direction in my life.
Jesus Christ. This guy is insane.
Is that a villain from a kid's show? I love it. How about just the fact that, you know, just don't talk about it anymore?
He stopped and everybody was cool. Dude, who the fuck brought him up in 3 months?
No, because, dude, you can't kill a reputation that doesn't exist. Like, he didn't have, like, this wasn't somebody that had a good reputation to begin with.
Yeah.
He was known as a guy as in the past few years that would no show. People didn't want to book him because of that. You know, people thought he was difficult to charge too much. So there were a lot of fucking reasons why he wasn't getting used.
But not even just that, though. I mean, if you just weigh out what he said and what he says now, this is totally different than like an Enzo Amore situation. Right. This is different than fucking Nash Carter. This is totally different than that. This is a scenario where you saw what happened online. You admitted that this happened, but it was a mistake. It was misunderstood. I didn't actually hit her on purpose. This was part of our martial arts training. There were no charges filed, like he said multiple times. And now you come back with this. These scandalous people have ruined my life and ended my wrestling career. He literally ended his own career. Do you know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
This is such a cry for help.
This is also a guy that's like 40. He should be glad that, dude, probably the best thing that can happen to you if you're not going to end up fucking rich from wrestling is somebody getting you out of it.
Yeah.
Honest to God. And I mean that in a funny way, but also in a serious way. Because if you're 40 years old, and at this point, it's like he's traveled everywhere. He's done everything he was going to do. You know what I mean? Like, he's made every dollar he probably was ever going to be able to make.
Yeah.
It's done. Like, it's done now. If somebody was like, hey, you don't have to wrestle anymore, we're going to fucking kick you out of the business, he should probably be like, good, because I might not have had the fucking restraint to do it myself. Like, clearly he hasn't.
But that's the thing, is like, if somebody came forward and said like, oh, Frontier Pro Wrestling doesn't want to use Ravy Ditchards because of allegations. Like, if they came forward and said, yeah, dude, we don't want to use you. Right. We just want nothing to do with you. You need to go the fuck away. That's different, because that's a victim of circumstance. Like people are fucking saying, that's a victim of circumstance, because then it is a he said, she said kind of thing. And then that gets ugly and nobody knows unless something comes out, blah, 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 blah. But this was, I'm going to cancel myself before you get a chance to. Nya, 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 nya. I retired. You can't hurt me. Nya, 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 nya. And well, it's like, then you come back 3 months later and goes, what do you mean that people don't want to see me anymore? It's like, I don't know, man.
How about just the fact that, like, looking at the way that shit is right now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
In some positions where people can make fucking tons of money. Did you hear about the kid that was the kicker for the Buffalo Bills? Do you know that whole story?
No. What happened there?
So there was a kid that got drafted as a punter, whatever, you know, whatever you want to call him. And the kid got accused of being involved in a gang with a girl that was not supposed to be there, a little bit too young to be there. And they found out after the fact that the kid wasn't even fucking there.
Right.
And so, you know, he lost his job in the NFL, you know, there was all the police and there was a huge investigation, all the shit they found out. Like, it was apparently the case was apparently so fucking cold and so off base with like the accusations that were against him and everybody else that basically every single person that worked in that jurisdiction was like, we have nothing. We have not, we can't work with any of this information. We couldn't try him. We couldn't try anybody. And so there you're taking somebody that was going to be a starter in an NFL team that was a Super Bowl contender, immediately overnight, wealthy, achieved his dream, playing in the NFL, and somebody stepped in and was like, hey, you know, we're going to fuck with this kid for whatever particular right. reason. That's not Davey Richards.
No.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Like, but I will say,
that's not a 40-year-old man who's probably made $200 a match for the past fucking 4 years, and the business has moved on from him. You know,
I'm sure the woman that accused Matt there will find herself sleeping one night and just hear, and that's it. That's the end of that story.
Jesus Christ. Somebody gonna shoot her with a blow dart?
Yeah,
is that what you're saying?
Blow darts through the pillow.
He's gonna send a whole bunch of Samoan linemen after her with
he's gonna hire Ravy Ditchard since he has nothing better to do.
Yeah. Oh my god. He's gonna be like, I just wanted to pass on my knowledge.
Follow Wrestling Soup on Twitter at Wrestling Soup. Like and subscribe to Wrestling Soup on YouTube. No. And check out the Discord for live chat during the shows at discord.gg/wrestlingsoup. Check out and subscribe to the shows on Apple, Amazon, iHeartRadio, Spotify,
and more.